Check one, check two, mic check.
Hello, it's Joseph, and welcome to part three of my lightsaber building series. If you haven't seen the first two parts yet, you'll find a playlist to my other prop building videos in the description. After I completed the first video in the series, I also created a Shoto saber using some extra parts that I had purchased. I never made a video for this because the main difference between the two builds is just that one was shorter and I didn't really feel that it would add much to the series. However, after I upgraded my main saber with a 3D printed chassis, I decided to do the same with my Shoto saber. Since I had taken detailed notes when designing the chassis for my main hilt, I was able to apply many of those dimensions to the Shoto chassis. The Shoto uses a gear piece just like the main saber, but only one ribbed extension, so the battery has to go underneath the CFX soundboard, and it didn't really leave room for an OLED screen. There is also a crystal chamber in the saber, but since the quartz crystal is a little shorter, I made a small adjustment to the mount holding it. To help get the BT909 Bluetooth module to fit inside the gear piece, I decided to use tactile switches instead of a 16mm anti-vandal switch. The PCB holder is a complete copy of the main saber's PCB holder. In fact, Fusion 360 allowed me to copy and paste a few parts in the model, such as the speaker holder, and I tweaked the dimensions after doing a few test prints. When it came time to print this chassis, I took Solo Saber's advice and printed it vertically. As you can probably tell, there is a better, smoother look to the chassis. Mainly, there is a less grainy texture to the plastic. So at the very least, part 2 and 3 of this video series is a good example of the different quality between horizontal and vertical printing of a lightsaber chassis. Or I'm just a rookie 3D printing artist and don't really know what I'm doing. But I'm learning. Since I had learned a lot from the installation process of the main hilt, I used mostly those steps to install everything in this chassis. The main difference in the process is that since the BT909 Bluetooth module is hidden inside the gear piece under the switches and behind the LED for the crystal chamber, I had to install the Bluetooth module after I installed the crystal LED, or I risked having all the other wiring getting in the way of that installation. The rest of the installation sequence is mostly the same. I install the recharge port after that, all the wires that need to pass through the crystal chamber, the battery holder, and switch sections are guided through their wire paths. Then the PCB and switches have their wires soldered into place. Then the speaker is installed. And once again, the battery was the last thing to be installed, though once it is put into its holder, it is really hard to remove. But if everything else is done correctly, the next time I will need to remove it is when it is at the end of its life. Now, I originally wanted tactile switches for the Shoto lightsaber. They save space, and I had designed some 3D printed buttons that I thought would look pretty cool. However, this took some precise drilling that I was unable to pull off for two reasons. The first was I just failed to do proper measurements ahead of time to line up the holes properly. Second, because I don't have a drill press and I use a hand drill, it was extremely difficult to drill in the precise spot needed so that the tactile switches on the chassis lined up with the holes. So most likely, if I want to do tactile switches, I'm going to have to retry this again later in the future. So after failing to drill the holes into the proper location, I just decided to purchase a set of low profile 12mm AV switches from the custom saber shop instead. There are other ways to install tactile switches. In fact, there's definitely better ways to install tactile switches into this type of lightsaber and chassis design, but I think for me in this case, I think the results turned out okay. I also took the opportunity to create a custom shroud for my Shoto saber, just like I did for my main hilt. First, I drew the shape I wanted on some blank paper. I tested it a few times on the saber itself. Then I put masking tape around the material that I cut, taped down the paper design after cutting it out, then traced where I wanted to cut. After cutting into the piece, I used my steel files to smooth out the edges and then used 832 set screws to hold the shroud in place. Well, just like the Saber, this is a shorter video than the others in the series so far. I hope you enjoyed watching that process, and hopefully that helps you in your lightsaber build. Be sure to check the description for links to resources that can help you in your lightsaber project. I added Shtok Neopixel PCBs to my lightsaber, which includes a ring of LEDs that will illuminate the inside of your blade holder. So in that Google Drive folder, you'll find the manual to the Shtok PCBs, and that could help you in wiring that up for your setup. Now, just so you know, I wired those up in parallel. There are multiple ways that you can wire them up, and I decided to use the parallel setup. If you're interested in understanding the difference between the parallel and series and things like that, not only read the manual, but feel free to leave a comment in the video to ask me questions about that. My future plans for my prop building series include doing some acid etching and powder coating, some painting and weathering of my sabers. But I also have some other ideas that I am planning out at this time, and I've actually already ordered the materials for those things, so keep an eye out for those videos as they come out in the future. There will also be a showcase video coming soon where I'll show you all the features of my Neopixel lightsabers. By the way, please be sure to go down into the description and click on the link to Solo Saber's tutorial videos on building a 3D printed chassis. Those videos were extremely helpful in helping me figure out how to build a 3D printed chassis. So if you are in any way interested in getting Fusion 360 and learning how to make your own 3D printed chassis, I can't recommend those videos enough to help you get started. Thank you to all of you who sent me encouraging comments over this last year. I'll see you next time I finish a project, and may the Force be with you.